the situation on the ground now? Is the fighting ongoing? Are the hostage situations ongoing as well?
Well, the fighting does seem to be ongoing in at least several locations in southern Israel. It's unclear exactly how many. There have been reports that some of the hostage situations have been resolved, but we are getting conflicting reports on exactly what's happening on the ground. The situation, as you know, is extremely tenuous. There's a lot of misinformation circulating and a lot of confusion as to what's actually happening on the ground in southern Israel, which, to be perfectly frank, reminds me of the day of 9/11. I was a high school senior in the DC area, and I remember just how devastating that day was and how much confusion there was during the course of those very tenuous and scary hours. This is numerically the equivalent of three 9/11s. You take Israel's population size into account. This is a devastating, devastating day for so many Israelis who are wondering whether their loved ones are kidnapped or killed and don't have that information at this time.
Yeah, some Israelis are comparing it not just to 9/11, but to Pearl Harbor as well. As you know, Avi, Hamas launched this very complex, multi-pronged attack. Do these tactics represent, from your perspective, an entirely new type of assault against Israel?
It certainly does seem so. Certainly with regard to the scale of the attack, the audacity of multi-pronged attack that took place by land, by air, and by sea, this is totally unprecedented. We've never seen anything like this, certainly with the number of casualties and the number of Israelis that have been abducted and taken into Gaza, which of course include elderly men and women, women and children, young people who were partying in the desert. They were dragged by Hamas into Gaza and being held there at this time. We've never encountered anything like this in Israel's long history.
Do you have any sense of how many Israelis have been abducted and kidnapped and taken into Gaza?
Well, I don't want to parrot Hamas talking points or psychological warfare, but I will tell you that the numbers appear to be quite high, and they include not only civilians, but also soldiers, perhaps even some senior commanders. We don't know whether that's the case. That's some of the information or misinformation that's been circulating in recent hours. We probably won't have clarity on that for another hours or perhaps several days as the situation becomes clearer and we get a clearer sense of exactly how many Israelis are being held in Gaza and how many unfortunately lost their lives in the earlier hours of today.
Yeah, we are told it's a very significant number, although specific numbers are not being released. The Israeli Prime Minister, as you know, Avi, Prime Minister Netanyahu has vowed to, quote, destroy Hamas. What will the Israeli response look like from your perspective?
What we're seeing now is wall-to-wall support for the IDF and, quite frankly, for Prime Minister Netanyahu. Both leaders of the opposition, Yair Lapid and Benny Gantz, have expressed their willingness to enter into an emergency unity government with the Prime Minister. That is apparently something that is currently under consideration. All Israelis are standing behind their government and their military as they do whatever they can to return the captives to Israel and to deal a devastating blow to Hamas and its leadership for having instigated this deadly attack today.
Avi Meir, the editor-in-chief of the Jerusalem Post, thank you very, very much for joining us.
Thank you.
Coming up, we'll have more on the breaking news coming out of Israel. The deadly and unprecedented Hamas attack today. We'll get reaction from a key lawmaker here in the United States.
My frequent heartburn had me taking antacid after antacid all day long. But with Prilosec OTC, just one pill a day blocks heartburn for a full 24 hours. For one and done heartburn relief, Prilosec OTC, one pill a day, 24 hours, zero heartburn.
Lactate is 100% real milk, just without the lactose. Delicious, too. Just ask my old friend Kevin.
Nothing like enjoying a cold one while watching the game. Who's winning?
We are, my friend. We are.
There are more identity threats than you realize. LifeLock alerts you and works to fix problems with a dedicated restoration specialist. Go to LifeLock.com.
Here's your parachute.
Certain it's okay? Are you foreign print certain?
Certainty matters, so congratulate coworkers or say thank you with promotional products from 4imprint.com.
4imprint, for certain.
I love my Knicks. I could not live without them.
Having period underwear makes life so much easier.
I don't think I could ever go back to just using pads and tampons. Just throw them in the laundry and it's super easy.
K-N-I-X. Knicks.
With Pi Prime, you can make pizza here, back here, and even way up here. You can make them fancy, like this, or keep it simple, like this. You can share with friends, or keep it all to yourself. You can be an artisan pizza pro, or maybe less so. You can do pizza your way with an oven that's simple enough to be your first and powerful enough to be your last. High Prime Pizza Oven by Solo Stove.
Sometimes it takes a different approach to imagine your future differently.
Thank you for coming together.
With Capella University's game-changing FlexPath format, take courses on your own terms and apply the skills you learn right away.
I've always been prone to hair thinning.
It was getting older.
I was under a lot of stress.
I started taking Nutrafol.
Nutrafol is the number one dermatologist-recommended hair growth supplement.
I am back to me.
Start your hair growth journey at Nutrafol.com.
You talk about chaos as if it's me forcing a few votes.
How disappointed are you with the speak what happened here and Speaker McCarthy?
I thought it was unfair.
We don't have a speaker. Eight of our members voted with all the Democrats to oust him.
Republicans struggling to figure out their way forward. What do you think of the chances of your party retaining control of the House next year?
So are you running for Speaker?
Yeah, what were your conversations like with Trump? You got his endorsement.
Manu Raju, CNN, Capitol Hill.
I've been pulled through time. If what I saw is true, there's nothing to stand between this world and utter destruction. It's up to us to save this place.
Is this crack?
Give it.
But you can only get your complimentary bottle by texting LEAN to 321-321.
That does it. I gotta get Nugenics.
Just send a text.
Yeah, for a complimentary bottle. And by the way, she'll like it too.
Get your complimentary bottle of Nugenics now. Text LEAN to 321-321. Text now and we'll include a bottle of Nugenics Thermo X, our newest, most powerful fat incinerator ever, with key ingredients to help you lose fat and get lean absolutely free. That's LEAN to 321-321.
I'm MJ Lee at the White House, and this is CNN.
Closed captioning brought to you by mesobook.com.
We only represent mesothelioma victims and their families. Call for a free book.
Call 800-282-4444 or go to mesobook.com.
The breaking news this hour, Israel reeling tonight from a massive attack by the terror group Hamas. Joining us now, a key Democrat in the House Foreign Affairs Committee, Congressman Grant Sherman of California. Congressman, thanks so much for joining us. You've been a member of the House Foreign Affairs Committee, what, for 28 years, ever since you came to Congress. What's your reaction to this unprecedented attack by Hamas against Israel?
This is Israel's 9/11. This will have to go on for some time because Israel is going to have to dismantle Hamas. They can't just absorb these casualties. And because if they do, then this will happen again 2 months from now, 4 months from now.
So what role should the U.S. have right now in dealing with all of this?
We should provide the tools and intelligence that Israel can use in the coming months, but also the diplomatic support, because there are already those who are telling Israel to stand down, to do nothing, to absorb the casualties and not respond. And in fact, Israel's going to have to respond. You can't leave this monster in Gaza any longer.
As you know, the former President Donald Trump, he issued a statement supporting Israel, but he also in that statement blamed President Biden for what's going on, calling him a weak leader. How do you respond to that?
Ridiculous, partisan, petty, and political. The fact is that under every president's watch, there has been terrorist action from Hamas. And this effort is an effort to derail what Biden is doing that's very good, which is the normalization between Israel and Saudi Arabia. So by coming close to a very important accomplishment, Hamas has gotten desperate and they've thrown everything they can against Israel.
So that normalization of relations between Israel and Saudi Arabia, from your perspective, is on hold right now.
It is. I'm not sure this will derail it, but it's clear that that's the purpose of this. I mean, look, Hamas wants to kill as many Israeli civilians as possible every day of the week. But they took an extraordinary action now because they see the possibility of normalization and something that gets the peace process moving. And Hamas, their announced and constant refrain is that they want to expel every Israeli from the Middle East. They will not no peace until all Jews are driven out.
As you know, the House of Representatives needs a Speaker of the House in order to get things accomplished. You really can't do anything without a Speaker. How is that going to affect what's going on with Israel right now?
I don't think it'll prevent us from doing what we need to do to help Israel. I think that providing the tools is something that the president can do with monies that have already been appropriated, and that's short term. The key is what we say off the floor and on the floor in special orders, to say that we stand with Israel. And I think the vast majority of members will be saying that and making it clear that we don't just stand with Israel when it's the victim. We stand with Israel when they do the necessary retaliation.
Because we're seeing a lot of statements of support for Israel coming from Democrats like you and Republicans, conservatives, and liberals. Do you see that going forward?
I think that keeps going. There may be some who take a step back when Israel does what it has to do. But Israel can't just be a victim in this case. It has to make itself safe for the future.
So you would support if Israel launches a massive ground invasion of Gaza right now to try to end the Hamas threat? You would support that?
If that's what Israel needs to do, I would support it, and I'd understand it. Because if you don't dismantle Hamas today, they're going to be back tomorrow.
How worried are you that Hezbollah in southern Lebanon and other terror groups in the West Bank, for example, could take what's going on in Gaza and Israel and begin other strikes against Israel right now?
You've got to be concerned about that, but the vast power of the Israeli Defense Forces are the civilians that are called up. And I would expect Israel to mobilize and to have more power on their northern border 2 weeks from now than they do today.
Yeah.
So I think Israel has had to fight on several fronts at once in 67 and 73, and of course in its War of Independence.
As a longtime member of the Foreign Affairs Committee, I know you're briefed by the U.S. intelligence community. What is the role of Iran in all of this?
Iran provides 70% of the financing for Hamas. 100% for its junior brother, who's also involved in these terrorist acts, Islamic Jihad. There is no way that this happened without either tacit or explicit encouragement from Iran, and that's why in the Iranian Majlis, their parliament, people are shouting death to Israel gleefully as they count up the number of women and children killed.
Congressman Brad Sherman of California, thanks so much for coming in.
Good to be with you.
Thank you. Just ahead, CNN is on the ground in Israel covering this historic Hamas attack. We'll get a live report right after this.
Sometimes the lows of bipolar depression feel darkest before dawn. With Caplyta, there's a chance to let in the light. Caplyta is proven to deliver significant relief across bipolar depression. Unlike some medicines that only treat bipolar 1, Caplyta treats both bipolar 1 and 2 depression. And in clinical trials, movement disorders and weight gain were not common.
Call your doctor about sudden mood changes, behaviors, or suicidal thoughts. Antidepressants may increase these risks in young adults. Elderly dementia patients have increased risk of death or stroke. Report fever, confusion, stiff or uncontrollable muscle movements, which may be life-threatening or permanent. These aren't all the serious side effects.
Caplyta can help you let in the light. Ask your doctor about Caplyta. Find savings and support at Caplyta.com.
The boys. The Niners. This rivalry on Sunday night is Cowboys and Niners, baby. Better get your popcorn ready.
We're not writers, but we help you shape your financial story. We're not an airline, but our network connects global businesses across nearly 160 markets. We're not a startup, but our innovation labs use new technologies to help keep your information secure. We're not architects, but we help build stronger communities. We're not just any bank. We are Citi.
We come from a long line of cowboys. When I see all of us out here on this ranch, I see how far our legacy can go.
I'll deal with this tomorrow.
You won't.
It's ripe in here.
My eyes are watering.
I'm a busy man.
Look how crusty this is.
Shameful.
It's just too much.
Not with this.
Tide.
Tide can tackle any pile.
Not a tackle bun?
Just clean the pile, Ron.
Okay.
too.
That was easy.
When stains and odors pile up, it's got to be Tide.
Dry skin is sensitive skin too, and it's natural. Treat it that way. Aveeno Daily Moisture with prebiotic oat is proven to moisturize dry skin all day. You'll love our formula for face too. Aveeno.
If we want a more viable future for our kids, we need to find more sustainable ways of doing things. America's plastic makers are investing billions of dollars in new technologies and creating plastic products that are more recyclable, durable, and dependable. Our goal is a cleaner, healthier planet for generations to come. For a better tomorrow, we're focused on making plastics better today.
It's a good day to cough. Oh, no.
Bye-bye, cough.
Later chest congestion. Hello, 12 hours of relief.
12 hours? Okay, not coughing at yoga. Antiquing, not coughing. Not coughing at the movies? Hashtag still not coughing?
Mucinex DM gives you 12 hours of relief from chest congestion and any type of cough, day or night. It's not cough season. It's always comeback season.
Sickness can spread fast, but with Lysol, you can go into protect mode. For the things you touch, nothing kills more viruses on more surfaces than Lysol disinfectant spray. And when it comes to your laundry, adding Lysol laundry sanitizer kills 99.9% of illness-causing bacteria. Detergents leave behind. Lysol, what it takes to protect.
We're back with breaking news, the massive and deadly Hamas assault on Israel. Let's bring back CNN International Diplomatic Editor Nick Robertson. He's right near the Israeli border with Gaza right now. Nick, do you get the sense that Israel has regained control of the Israeli communities right near the border?
Regained or regaining, it's very hard to tell. You know, the indications from here, we're just 2.5 miles from the border with Gaza, perhaps a few more miles to Sderot, there was a sort of semi-siege situation there as well, perhaps a little further from another one of those communities that was understood for civilians to be under siege there. The helicopter gunship that we heard overhead before, we really haven't heard that in the last, I would say, 15 or 20 minutes perhaps, and it was quite prevalent over the previous hour, which does seem to indicate that the fight that helicopter was supporting troops on the ground in is perhaps over. It does feel as if potentially some of those situations are being eased, but really in terms of security here, that area, you know, this police checkpoint here, is still considered an active combat zone, and we haven't been here given an all clear that it's safe to go in there as of yet. But the sort of battle tempo, if you will, that we could hear before has diminished. But we are, having said that, seeing bigger explosions on the horizon behind me. Those seem to be coming from directly inside Gaza itself, Wolf.
Have you seen a change in on-the-ground presence, for example, of Israeli troops over the past few hours? I know you've been there at least a couple hours in Zikim, Israel, along right near the border with Gaza.
It's nighttime, so it's a little hard to tell who's in the vehicles that are passing here. Some of the buses look as if they could be evacuating civilians that are leaving where we are here, coming away from the Gaza area, headed towards the north, headed towards Tel Aviv. But we have seen a convoy of military vehicles, or vehicles full of soldiers, headed south towards Gaza. We haven't seen a movement of heavy military equipment, but I think it's perhaps too soon to expect to see that. I think for right now, the focus has been on regaining control of these areas here, so it's safe to begin to deploy more forces into, to ramp up what potentially could become an incursion force. As we've seen it down here before, just further down the road from here is where you will see the Israeli Defense Force line up its military equipment, get ready for an order that would push it in across the borderline across the fence line and go into Gaza itself. Not seeing that yet, Wolf.
We know that the Israeli military has activated, mobilized thousands of reservists to get ready for a potential war. We'll watch as all this sample today. We'll get back to you. Right now, we're over here at the Magic Wall to get some insights on the fighting that's going on. See, the military analyst, retired Colonel Cedric Layton, is with us. Colonel Layton, thanks so much for joining us. Give us a closer look at the places that Hamas has attacked.
Absolutely, Wolf. So when you go right into the area, this is where Zikin is, where Robertson was right now in this last report that he gave. So it's right close to the Gaza border. These are all the areas that have been attacked. And if you step out here and look at the broader map, what you can see is Gaza is right here, this area right here. This is the launching pad for the Hamas attacks into Israel in this way. West Bank is here. The Egyptian-controlled Sinai, Jordan, Golan Heights, Syria, Lebanon up here. All of these are part of the environment that Israel has to deal with, as you know so well. But this is the area in which all of these attacks came from.
I know you're watching all of this explode right now, but you're also keeping a very close eye on the cyber threat that's unfolding right now. Tell us about that.
So what you're looking at when it comes to the cyber threat, Wolf, is that there have been a series of what they're calling distributed denial of service attacks against the Israeli networks. And those Israeli networks are ones that actually are controlling the emergency services in particular, and they're also going after police and other networks there. So Hamas has been responsible for those. They've been using their launch sites in Gaza to do this, and the Israelis are setting up defensive perimeters in the cyber sense to go after the attackers from Hamas that are based in Gaza, plus others that are based in other places like Iran.
I'm worried, should the Israelis be about a Hezbollah attack from southern Lebanon into northern Israel, Haifa, and some other places?
Absolutely. I think this would be one of the areas that we could see the possibility of the folks from Hezbollah actually coming in and potentially using this area to create diversionary attacks for the Israelis. Also, we have to watch the West Bank. So between Hezbollah, Hamas in Gaza, the West Bank, the Palestinian Authority there, all of these areas could potentially pose further dangers for the Israeli Defense Forces.
I know you have some satellite images you want to share with our viewers as well. Tell us about that.
Absolutely, Wolf. So these satellite images are actually quite interesting because this line right here, this is the border right here between Israel and Gaza. And you see this is the Mediterranean Sea right here. And you can tell that when you look at each of these satellite images, and you see this one here as well, this is more of an east-west look. This is Israel right here. This is Gaza. Agricultural land here, more crowded areas here, also agricultural land. But this is the area in which the Hamas forces came through and basically bulldozed their way through the fence line into Israel proper. And when it came to that, these areas right here were the ones that were attacked by the Hamas forces right along this border.
These Israeli towns and kibbutzim that are along the border, and a lot of civilians, Israeli civilians, were kidnapped, captured, and taken into Gaza, and they're there right now. That's a deep, deep source of concern for the Israelis. Colonel Cedric Layton, as usual, thank you very, very much. Coming up, I'll get reaction to all the breaking news out of Israel from the former Defense Secretary and former CIA Chief, Leon Panetta. He's standing by live.
The day you give your Clear Choice dental implants makes every day a let's dig in day, a chow down day, a take a big bite day, a perfectly delicious day, a love my new teeth day. Because your Clear Choice day is the day everything is back on the menu. A Clear Choice day changes every day. Schedule a free consultation.
Your ancestry is so much more than names and dates. It's the story of your family then and now. A story that made your name mean something. A story you're still writing. So discover your heritage. Preserve your traditions. Represent all that makes you. Hey, humans, what if you could accomplish something instead of endlessly following up? How about if you collaborated with other humans in other departments? What if making a project template was quicker than putting on work pants?
What if you could keep up with projects without chasing other humans down? What if how humans work actually works for humans? Operate at peak human. Smart Chief.
Dry skin is sensitive skin too, and it's natural. Treat it that way with Aveeno Daily Moisture. Formulated with nourishing prebiotic oak, it's clinically proven to moisturize dry skin for 24 hours. Aveeno.
Antarctica. You have to experience it to truly appreciate the beauty, the wildlife, the sheer majesty. Experience it with state-of-the-art expedition equipment and hands-on scientific research activities, all in exceptional Viking comfort. We invite you to discover the world's seventh continent, Antarctica. Viking, exploring the world in comfort.
What's yellow?
Oh, Schwan's Home Delivery has a new name, like a freezer full of happy.
Happy like this? Yeah!
More options, easier ordering. Now at yellow.com.
Lactate is 100% real milk, just without the lactose. Delicious, too. Just ask my old friend Kevin.
Nothing like enjoying a cold one while watching the game. Who's winning?
We are, my friend. We are.
Want to pay only $40 per month with Sling TV to watch CNN, HGTV, MSNBC, and your other favorite channels? You can stream it all on Sling, all for just $40 per month. Try Sling today at sling.com/watchnow.
It's real anymore. CNN brings you unparalleled coverage.
Following major breaking news
on the ground. With the latest developments.
The sirens have gone off. People are taking cover.
For continuing coverage, stay with CNN.
Look, isn't that Frank Thomas?
Oh, the big hurt.
More like the big hunk. Wow, Frank Thomas.
Hi, how's it going?
Good. You look like you could still be playing. That's what I said.
Well, I am feeling stronger and leaner.
So, Frank, what's your secret?
I discovered eugenics.
I wish my husband did.
It's easy. Just send a text.
If you're a guy over 40, text FIXED to 231-231. To get a complimentary sample of Nugenix Total T, the number one selling free testosterone booster at GNC. Nugenix is a unique man-boosting formula powered by Testofen, a patented key ingredient clinically researched to help boost your free testosterone levels. To help you feel stronger, leaner, with more energy and drive. More passion, too.
Here, try a bottle. And trust me, she'll like it, too.
Text FIXED to 231-231 to get a complimentary sample of Nugenix Total T. Text now and we'll include a bottle of Nugenix Thermo X, our most powerful fat incinerator ever. Absolutely free. That's FIXED to 231-231.
I'm Paris Canal outside of New York State Courthouse, and this is CNN.
We're following the breaking news. Palestinian militants from Hamas have attacked Israel, killing at least, this is a new number, at least 250 people in Israel. And a significant number of Israeli civilians and military personnel have been kidnapped and taken to Gaza. That according to an IDF spokesperson. Joining us now to discuss this and more, the former U.S. Defense Secretary, Leon Panetta. Mr. Secretary, thanks so much for joining us. First of all, what strikes you most about how Hamas actually carried out this unprecedented attack against Israel?
Well, there's no question that it was a well-planned attack by Hamas. They were able to infiltrate some of their troops into Israel without being detected by Israeli intelligence. They were able to gather a number of missiles that they then launched. There's no question that it was a surprise attack. And Israel was surprised by that attack. And I can tell you, the one thing Israel does not like is to be surprised by an attack. But that's exactly what's happened here.
You're also not only the former defense secretary, you're also the former director of the CIA. What do you make, Mr. Secretary, of the fact that Israeli intelligence appears to have been completely caught off guard by this Hamas assault?
Well, I think there's a problem with intelligence these days where there's very heavy reliance on kind of technology and space and surveillance. Too often they forget the important approach to intelligence, which is human intelligence, people on the ground who are paying attention to what's happening. And so Hamas here obviously avoided the kind of high-tech surveillance that's usually done on intelligence, and it was pretty deliberate on their part. They were able to deploy these individuals without the intelligence picking any of that up. I think there's no question that that the intelligence system in Israel did not do well here, and they're going to have to take a hard look at how to improve that.
Yeah, human intelligence is so critically important, even amidst all the high technology that's going on right now. Prime Minister Netanyahu says, Mr. Secretary, that Israel will, quote, take mighty vengeance for this black day. How do you anticipate Israel will now respond?
Well, I don't think there's any question that Israel is going to take vengeance, particularly as a result of this significant number of Israeli citizens that have been taken hostage. Israel is not going to stand back and allow that to happen. So make no mistake about it, we are at the beginning of a prolonged war. I think Israel is going to mobilize, and they're going to deploy their forces, and they're going to do everything they can to make sure that they are able to bring those Israelis back to their families. So this is going to be a prolonged war.
Yeah, that's what I suspect as well. What role, Mr. Secretary, do you see the U.S. playing in supporting Israel as it responds to this terror attack?
I think the United States obviously has a special relationship with Israel. We will provide, I'm sure, military support. I'm sure we'll provide whatever kind of intelligence that they may need. I think the big challenge right now is going to be one of intelligence, very frankly, to be able to locate where these hostages are and then be able to determine what kind of operation is going to be taken in order to rescue those hostages. This is going to be a complicated effort. And I think the United States can help Israel in trying to provide both the intelligence as well as the military support needed in order to make that mission accomplished.
Give us some history, Mr. Secretary. How does this attack compare with past assaults on Israel?
You know, one of the things we've seen going back to 1948, the roots of this conflict were planted then and have continued throughout the years. We've had 7 decades of wars and uprisings and efforts, failed efforts, unfortunately, to try to find peaceful solutions. And there's no question that this last past year, the tensions between Palestinians and Israelis continued to increase. There were attacks. There are a number of Palestinians that have been killed. Israelis that have been killed. We kind of didn't pay attention to the amount of tensions that were arising. And so ultimately, Hamas took this step, this dramatic step, and nobody saw it coming. So it's a wake-up call, very frankly. If Israel wants to protect its security, it's going to have to pay attention to the efforts that Hamas is involved with, that Iran is involved with, that Hezbollah is involved with, if they're going to protect their country.
Yeah, not only the Israelis didn't see this coming, I don't think the U.S. intelligence community saw it coming either, but we will do more checking on that. The former Defense Secretary Leah Panetta, thanks so much for joining us.
Good to be with you.
And we'll have more of the breaking news coverage coming up right after this quick break.
Viruses and bacteria float all around us. Unlike air fresheners, only new Lysol air sanitizer kills 99.9% of viruses and bacteria in the air. Because scent can't sanitize, Lysol can.
At SimpliSafe, we build advanced security sensors and cameras for your whole home. Powered by 24/7 professional monitoring and Fast Protect technology, exclusively from SimpliSafe for faster police response. There's no safe like SimpliSafe.
The virus that causes shingles is sleeping in 99% of people over 50, and it can strike at any time. Think you're not at risk? Wake up, because shingles could wake up in you. If you're over 50, talk to your doctor or pharmacist about shingles prevention.
Last year, I got stuck paying for my ex's internet for months before I finally caught it. That won't happen this year, thanks to Rocket Money.
finds hidden subscriptions, and you can cancel the ones you don't want with one tap. Join Rocket Money today.
If you're smart enough to know a good wireless deal when you see one, listen up. And if you're not, we'll give you a minute. Smart enough now? Good. At Consumer Cellular, we're all about transparency. We deliver premium wireless coverage for up to half of what the largest carriers charge. How do we do it? I'll show you. The truth is, we don't actually own those towers. We just pay to use them. And while someone else maintains that great nationwide 5G network, we've got more time to focus on something else. You. Boom! Say hello to one of our 100% U.S.-based customer service call centers. If you need help or want to make the easy switch, you can call and talk to a real person in Arizona, like Danae here.
Yep, I'm definitely a real person, not a robot.
Prove it. Amazing coverage and award-winning service, all with no contract. Just give us a call at this number.
Switch to Consumer Cellular now and get unlimited talk and text with a flexible data plan starting at only $20 a month.
This is the carry-on closet, the suitcase with a one-of-a-kind patented closet system that keeps you organized anywhere. Pack all you need for up to 10 days. Travel without ever unpacking. The comfort of home, on the go. Unpack in seconds at soulguard.co.
Whether you want a quick snack or a perfectly sized portion, Bob Evans 2-pound single serve cups has you covered. Heat up a helping of creamy mashed potatoes or gooey mac and cheese and enjoy. Bring home the goodness of Bob Evans today.
I would always try and kind of hide my face because you could see my spots.
Stop suffering from melasma with Muesli Face RX. The spot cream is 10 times more potent than over-the-counter and prescription alternatives.
Nothing has worked until Muesli.
Does someone who threatens Putin's power ever die unintentionally in Russia?
I don't think so. He just leaves all this carnage in his wake.
You think he cares about that?
No, he doesn't.
Who is responsible for that image?
I take responsibility for anything that happens in this city.
How dependent is the government on Elon Musk?
The answer to your question is, we are very, very beholden to Elon Musk.
The Source with Caitlin Collins, Monday at 9.
Guy,
I belong here.
You may think I don't fit in.
That I don't look the part.
But to me, curling is more than a sport.
It's my community.
Together, we can sweep away the barriers.
Create spaces where we all belong.
And experience the joy of curling. I belong here.
We belong here. We unite. And united we curl.
Question. How's your money management game? I tried spreadsheets, post-it notes, and mental math, but could never keep up with everything. That's why I started Rocket Money, an app to lower bills, find and cancel unwanted subscriptions, and bring your entire financial picture into focus. Download Rocket Money today.
When Lila was ready to sell her ring, she sent it to Worthy, where they took care of everything and auctioned it on her terms. Then, Worthy sent Lila her money. You're worthy of more. Get started at Worthy.com.
I'm Dr. Sanjay Gupta, and this is CNN.
You've been watching our special coverage of the breaking news out of the Middle East, where Israel has come under attack by air, land, and sea. Hamas militants killing at least, this is a new number, at least 300 Israelis and wounding over 1,000 more, this according to Israeli officials. Tomorrow, the U.S. Secretary of State, Antony Blinken, will join my friend and colleague, Dana Bash, on CNN's State of the Union. That's at 9 a.m. and noon Eastern. And I'll be back in the Situation Room tomorrow evening, 6 p.m. Eastern, for our special coverage of Israel at War. Thanks very much for watching. I'm Wolf Blitzer in the Situation Room. CNN's special breaking news coverage continues right now with Aaron Burnett on coverage.
Good evening, I'm Erin Burnett. Welcome to a special edition of Out Front, Israel at War. The breaking developments at this hour, the death toll rising as the sound of sirens and explosions can be heard across southern and central Israel after a surprise attack by Hamas. An Israeli official says at least 300 Israelis have been killed. The former Prime Minister of Israel, Naftali Bennett, telling me that the ultimate death toll will be, quote, much higher. And tonight, there are reports that gun battles are still taking place nearly 24 hours after militants first entered Israel by land and sea and air, firing 22.
2,200 rockets, according to Israel. And this new video, which I'm going to show you right now, shows heavily armed Hamas fighters moving through one neighborhood. You can hear the sound of gunfire and screams as militants try to force their way into homes. There's just people at home, militants, just forcing their way in. I mean, the terror is hard to even comprehend. And tonight, there are other horrific scenes emerging of Israelis being kidnapped off the streets. In this video, you see a woman, her face covered in blood, as she's taken from the trunk of a Jeep and shoved into the back seat. Her arms also appear to be zip-tied. Now, according to Hamas, those captured are, quote, present in all axes in the Gaza Strip. What happens to the people of the Gaza Strip will happen to them, and beware of miscalculation. Well, of course, the hostage issue complicates Israel's efforts to respond. This enormous and highly coordinated assault was a catastrophic failure of intelligence. And in the words of Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu, what happened today has never been seen in Israel. And tonight, the situation on the verge of exploding into an even deadlier conflict, the military win of Hamas, warning Israel of a, quote, earth-shattering response after Israel responded to this attack, airstrikes hitting a group of high-rises in Gaza. The buildings, as you can see, collapsing. Palestinians say at least 230 of their people have been killed since Israel returned fire. Tonight at the White House, President Biden and his administration are closely monitoring the situation, and our team of reporters is standing by. Nick Robertson and Hadass Gold are out front live in Israel tonight. Kayla Tausche is at the White House, and Oren Lieberman is in Washington tonight. I want to begin, though, with Nick, just over a mile from the Gaza border. And Nick, obviously, we're 24 hours into this now. You are in the wee hours of the morning here. What is the latest there right now?
Yeah, we're hearing fighter jets overhead. We're hearing explosions in the vicinity of Gaza. There are, if we look up here, you can see there are these illumination flares that are being put up in the sky by the Israeli military, because just over the hill there, just below that flare, that's a beach area, and the Hamas militants were trying to land on that beach as recently as this evening, we've been told. But that zone behind me here, more flares in the sky above it there, that is looking down towards Gaza. That is the area below those flares where it is an active military ongoing situation with Israeli defense forces are trying to round up all the Hamas militants that have gotten into Israel today. The fight is still going on. We're seeing military traffic coming and going up and down this road. Helicopter gunships as well. We're hearing their heavy machine guns firing into that area. But all this began unraveling, unfolding in an utterly unexpected way for Israeli citizens. Just less than 24 hours ago, early hours of Saturday morning. In the early hours of Saturday, Israelis woke to a sudden assault from Gaza militants. The surprise attack, claimed by the Palestinian militant group Hamas, a complex and massive operation marking a steep escalation of hostilities. The attack began with a huge barrage of missiles fired from Gaza, thousands of rockets, some making direct hits on targets across southern Israel. Under the cover of the missiles, a large-scale infiltration began as Hamas militants crossed by land, sea, and air, even using paragliders to cross into Israel. Videos from border crossing stations show Hamas fighters storming into Israeli territory. A few miles away in the border town of Sderot, Hamas was seen driving and opening fire at civilians. The gunmen tore through the streets, leaving a trail of casualties behind. The full extent of the casualties is unclear, but hundreds have been killed and more than 1,000 injured on both sides. A spokesman for the Israeli Defense Force gave a frank assessment of the situation.
A very severe morning here in Israel. A combined offensive by Hamas, ground, air, and sea. The numbers still are not clear. We're not going to talk about the numbers as we speak, but the numbers are substantial. A very severe morning. We are very much now focused on sending forces to these locations where there's ongoing fighting as we speak.
During the raid, some fighters also took Israelis as hostages and prisoners of war, the Israeli military said. Videos geolocated by CNN show militants taking civilians captive in southern Israel and Gaza. A woman is seen forced out of her car and into the custody of Hamas. Israel quickly retaliated, hitting multiple targets along the Gaza Strip. In Gaza City, two high-rise buildings collapsed after an airstrike. The unrest continuing late into the night, with both sides trading rocket fire. As we touch down at Ben Gurion International Airport outside Tel Aviv, air traffic was halted as sirens wailed and travelers took cover. Literally just got off the plane here at Ben Gurion. The sirens have gone off, people are taking cover. We got off the bus, people are taking cover, and you can hear the intercept missiles banging in the air. Nothing incoming here, but everyone is taking cover. They've got down. A lot of concern about what's going to happen here this night. Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu has been unwavering in his message that Israel is at war with Hamas. Now Israel rushes to regroup with its allies. Despite the intelligence failure that appeared to lead to the attack, it is clear that the true force of the Israeli government's response is yet to come. And that's what we're seeing building up through the night here. As we've been standing here on this road for the past 2 or 3 or 4 hours, maybe now, we've been able to hear an increase in the fighter jet activity, an increase in the number of impacts coming from the Gaza area, an increase in the flashes on the sky, but it's just not clear. We're just going to turn the camera, John, if you can point the camera over there, to that light on the horizon. That is probably maybe 5 or 6 miles away. That is Sderot. That is one of the areas that the Hamas militants stormed into earlier today. And it's still not entirely clear to us if the Israeli Defense Forces still have full control of that area. So the hits going and coming down, Israeli hits coming down on Gaza. But at the same time, the Israeli Defense Forces still trying to get back control of all of their own territory.
All right, Nick, thank you very much. We're going to be speaking to a spokesperson for the Israel Defense Forces in just a moment. I want to go to the White House first, though. Kayla Tausche's there. Kayla, obviously the White House was very clearly caught off guard by this as well. What is the response from there tonight?
Well, Aaron, senior officials have raised concerns about the surprise nature of this ambush, with one intelligence official telling CNN that there will need to be an after-action report to determine whether there was intelligence that this was coming and it was simply missed, or whether there was just a massive blind spot. Tonight, a senior administration official denying that there was a warning from a third country such as Egypt that this attack was coming, and saying that the focus at this moment is on keeping the violence contained and figuring out how best the U.S. can support Israel. To that end, the White House is acknowledging tonight that there are unique challenges here in Washington posed by the lack of a current Speaker of the House of Representatives, as well as the lack of a permanent ambassador from the U.S. to Israel, and said that there are conversations up and down the military chain to figure out how to get some of that aid in a quick, fulsome, and timely manner to Israel, and that there could be an announcement as soon as tomorrow. President Biden says that support will be unwavering and rock solid, and he had a warning to any party hostile to Israel not to exploit these attacks. To that end, Aaron, the White House and senior officials have said that it is too early to determine whether Iran had any involvement in the attacks overnight, but suggested that Iran, as a longtime benefactor of Hamas, cannot be denied that it was indirectly involved at the very least, Aaron.
At the very least. All right. Thank you very much, Kayla, at the White House tonight. And out front now, Lieutenant Colonel Jonathan Conricus. He is the international spokesperson of the Israel Defense Forces. And Colonel, I appreciate your time. I'm very sorry to be speaking to you tonight, and I know you are sleepless again as you work through the night. Nick Robertson was 5 or 6 miles from Sderot. He was saying that it was unclear whether the IDF had full control of that area or full control of all Israeli territory at this time. Are you able to answer that question? Does Israel have full control?
At this time, unfortunately, I cannot yet say that we have regained full control over all of our communities and all of our sovereign territory. There is still fighting ongoing in southern Israel. We are still, our forces, special forces and reserve forces, are going door to door, house to house, reaching out to all of the Israeli civilians that were holed up there during the one such situation just ended positively in a kibbutz called Be'eri, where Israeli hostages were released by Israeli troops and they were held by terrorists. The terrorists were killed, but there is still fighting ongoing, and I don't think that we'll be able to say with confidence that we have regained full control of the area until the crack of dawn tomorrow. It is an unprecedented situation here in Israel. The unprecedented attack, the sheer brutality of the violence against our civilians, the fact that they have paraded women, elderly, children, and men as well into Gaza, that they have taken such a significant number of Israelis into Gaza and are holding them captive, is something that we have not faced before. And an unprecedented attack will call for an unprecedented response against Hamas.
You talk about the significant number of hostages, and you were just saying there, thank goodness, that there's been one situation that has ended positively. The Hamas militants were killed by members of the IDF in that. How many Israeli hostages were rescued, and how many more do you think are out there? And I know it may be obviously hard for you to be specific, but are we talking hundreds of people? Are we talking dozens of people?
We are most likely talking dozens of people at this time, but numbers are very dynamic, and I'm sure you're familiar with the term the fog of war. This is an extremely foggy situation. We have today, during today, there were more than 25 active fighting events inside Israel, locations like communities, IDF bases, and places of gatherings where there were active terrorists fighting, either taking hostages or running crazy on the streets, killing Israeli civilians. And now we're down to a significantly lower number, but not yet over. The bigger and most important figure, I think, is unfortunately the number of Israelis held in Gaza. I cannot say how many, but I can say that it is a substantial number of civilians as well as military personnel. Some are presumed alive according to video footage, and some are presumed not to be alive. But it's an extremely delicate situation. I think that will influence future decision making in Israel of how we continue here. And it's something that we haven't faced before, but that we are determined to set a swift end to.
Yeah, absolutely. And obviously that, when you talk about an unprecedented response, the hostage situation plays a crucial role in that. Are there any communications at all right now, Colonel, going on between Israel and Hamas, directly or through any intermediaries, to try and get the Israeli citizens and civilians back?
Even if there were, I'm not sure that I would be aware of them. But based on previous situations, that is not how Hamas operates. They launched this attack into Israel in order to abduct Israeli civilians and soldiers, in order to kill as many as possible Israelis. That's why they launched this this outstanding operation that they did, something that we've never seen before. I don't think that they will try to negotiate so soon, but that is, I think, besides the point. What we are focusing on now is making sure that the border is shut and defended, and that there are no further attacks into Israel. And we have already started striking military targets in Gaza. And it's important that this time, and this is really an important message for me, this is how it started. We're on the first day of a war in Israel. This is how it started. And there will be images in the coming days and weeks of a difficult situation inside Gaza. But I urge people to remember, this is how it started. It started with a Hamas attack into Israel, unprovoked and unprecedented. And this is why we are responding, and we will respond with tremendous force.
Colonel, I appreciate your time. Thank you very much. I know, sir, you have obviously not slept, and you're in the middle of this, and you will continue to work in these early hours until dawn. Thank you.
Thank you.
And our breaking news coverage continues here. We're going to go back to the ground in Israel, where Palestinian militants have fired more rockets, people nearby rushing to nearby bomb shelters. plus Hamas claiming dozens of Israelis are taken as hostages, and you just heard the colonel talking about this situation. Our next guest says that his wife and two daughters were taken hostage, and the moment that it happened was caught on camera.
Stanley Steamer is proud to clean over 1 million homes across America every year. With custom-made vans and cleaning equipment, our professional cleaning technicians have the knowledge and skills to get your home cleaner and healthier. Get the best for your home. Schedule a cleaning with your local Stanley Steamer today.
I wish for the amazing new iPhone 15 Pro.
You mean this one, the one with titanium?
No way, I could trade this busted-up thing for one.
Maybe stealing wishes from the birthday boy is not your best plan. Switch to Verizon and trade in any iPhone and get the new iPhone 15 Pro on them.
What?
Yep, and on an amazing network.
And I don't have to ruin any more birthday parties.
Yeah, that ship has sailed. Let's go get you that iPhone.
Here we go.
Come on.
Trade in any iPhone in any condition for a new iPhone 15 Pro on us. Only on Verizon.
If you want to lower stroke risk from AFib, not caused by a heart valve problem, there's a better treatment than warfarin. Eliquis. Eliquis reduces stroke risk and has less major bleeding.
Don't stop taking Eliquis without talking to your doctor, as this may increase your risk of stroke. Eliquis can cause serious and, in rare cases, fatal bleeding. Don't take Eliquis if you have an artificial heart valve or abnormal bleeding. While taking, you may bruise more easily or take longer for bleeding to stop. Get help right away for unexpected bleeding or unusual bruising. It may increase your bleeding risk if you take certain medicines. Tell your doctor about all planned medical or dental procedures.
The number one cardiologist-prescribed blood thinner. Ask your doctor about Eliquis.
I brought in Ensure Max Protein with 30 grams of protein. Those who tried me felt more energy in just 2 weeks. Here, I'll take that.
Ensure Max Protein. 30 grams of protein, 1 gram sugar, 25 vitamins and minerals, and nutrients for immune health.
Sometimes all the tenacity and grit in the world can't overcome the boundaries we face. Morgan Stanley is partnering with the Women's Tennis Association to remove them. Because this game is for everybody.
This delectable ramen noodle recipe will put an end to your drive-thru dinner rituals. Throw that powder in that tasty combo of delightful carrots and rich ketchup bok choy. No more taste combos. It's not fast food, but it's so good.
Stay 2 nights and get 5,000 bonus points. Book direct at bestwestern.com.
Messy happens. When it does, there's HomaGlow. For just $19, HomaGlow will clean your entire house. Everything from dishes to vacuuming, even laundry. Join thousands of Americans and book your first cleaning today for just $19.
With GoBond, you can age on your own terms. Retinol Overnight means the smooth benefits of retinol are now for your whole body. Plus, fast-working Quick Corrector diminishes wrinkled skin in just 2 days. GoBond, champion your skin.
Anyone who's ever sold a home will tell you it's really hard, and it's one of the biggest financial decisions you'll ever make. That's why who you work with matters. Together with HomeLight, we take care of every detail.
New video into CNN coming in right now. Scary moments as this attack unfolded. Hundreds of people running from gunfire at a festival. This as several images are coming out of innocent civilians being captured as Hamas launches this attack on Israel. Those are the people running, as you can see, from the festival. And then the hostages still being held by Hamas, as far as we know. You just heard the spokesperson for the IDF talking about dozens of hostages. And we want to show you some video that we have here of a woman. It appears to show a woman being pulled from the trunk of a Jeep at gunpoint. Her wrists appear to be tied behind her back. She's then forced into the back seat of this car. Several men are yelling out. This all caught on camera. One man also sharing this video with Out Front, saying that it shows his wife and two young children, his young daughters, who are 5 and 3 years old, being taken to Gaza. Now, CNN hasn't been able to independently verify this video, but we are going to speak to him in just a moment. Those are his wife and children. But first, Hadass Gold is out front. She's in Jerusalem at this hour. And Hadass, what are Israeli officials saying about the hostages? It sounds like, even talking to the spokesperson for the IDF just a few moments ago, this is a very dynamic situation. They don't seem to even know full numbers.
I think that, Aaron, probably at this point, they do have at least a sense of the numbers, but they are being very cagey about the details, and they're still working out exactly who was where and what happened. But they have confirmed that both Israeli soldiers and civilians have been taken as what they call prisoners of war. Aaron, this is in addition to people who were being held hostage in southern Israel, who hadn't been managed to be taken from Israeli territory into Gaza. We know of at least one hostage situation in Be'eri that reportedly had just been resolved in the last few hours, although we know firefights are still continuing in southern Israel. Again, we don't have numbers, but I know that these numbers in terms of prisoners of war taken by Hamas, they are said to be in the dozens. We're not talking about one or two. We're not talking about even five. Keep in mind that in previous situations, a single Israeli prisoner of war has launched wars, has caused massive prisoner exchange, has been a major, major issue. So now we're talking about dozens. And again, these are not just soldiers, as we've been seeing from these videos, as we've been seeing from accounts from Israeli families. These are civilians, including children, including some of whom have been taken from the streets, from their homes, because Israeli militants had Hamas militants had infiltrated Israeli towns and were going house by house and trying to get into these houses and take people out. This is an incredible situation that Israel has never been in before. It's being likened to Israel's Pearl Harbor, or potentially even worse. As of right now, an Israeli official telling me that there are 300 Israelis who have been killed. We know of more than 1,500 who have been injured. These numbers are likely to rise because there are still towns in southern Israel that have not been completely cleared of militant activity. And the rockets are continuing as we speak. I'm still getting notifications of red alert sirens going off in southern Israel. Now, it's been quieter for the rest of the country. Here in Jerusalem, we had our own fair share of sirens and rockets targeting Jerusalem earlier today. Tel Aviv had a barrage a few hours ago. Those have since quieted down for now, but they are continuing. This is a very tense and unfolding situation. The Israeli military is attacking the Gaza Strip with airstrikes. So far, it's only been airstrikes. It has not been a ground invasion yet. The Israeli military just recently actually sending out a warning to civilians in Gaza, telling them to leave certain areas, to go to certain safe areas, as they are calling them, where they should evacuate to, indicating they're expecting a large-scale attack. But now, Aaron, the situation is very complicated there, because whatever sort of airstrikes, attacks that the Israeli military may want to undertake in the Gaza Strip, they also have to keep in mind the number of hostages. And Hamas has said they have taken some of these prisoners of war to strategic places throughout the Gaza Strip, obviously trying to use them as shields of some kind. This is an incredibly tricky and very dangerous situation for this entire region.
So, Hadass, thank you very much. Hadass is live in Jerusalem tonight. And I want to go now to Yoni Asher, who is in Israel, desperately looking for his wife and his children after he saw them in this viral video. Saw this video, and that's when he found out that they appeared to be taken hostage near the Gaza Strip. And Yoni, I am so sorry for what you are suffering through. I don't think any parent can truly comprehend your daughters, your wife. I know your daughters are very young, 5 and 4 years old. Do you have any idea, Yoni, where they are?
I have no idea where they are right now, but earlier this morning they were visited in kibbutz near Oz, in my mother-in-law's house on the kibbutz, and they were taken by Hamas to Gaza Strip. My mother-in-law, my wife, my two daughters, which are 5-year-old and 3-year-old, and I lost contact with them about 11 a.m. When my wife was me on the phone, she told me that the terrorists of Hamas entered the house, and later on the conversation was disconnected. Later on I managed to track her mobile phone by using Google, and I tracked her mobile phone and I saw that the location is in Gaza Strip, in Gaza, in Khan Yunis. And later on I saw the video which confirmed that my wife and my daughters were taken, like you see in the video that is on the social media, that everyone saw. And I all day long I talked to press and I tried to talk to officials from the state, but no one talked to me yet. I don't think they know what is the situation regarding the hostage. And the situation is not looking good. My wife, my father-in-law also have German citizenship. So with your permission, I would like to approach the German government, German Prime Minister, dear Mr. Olaf Scholz, and the German ambassador, Mr. Seven Sager, my wife, the one German citizen who was taken with her mother, a German citizen today by Hamas terrorists to Gaza. I beg you, if you can please help us. We are begging for your help, for you, if you can do something to succeed to take my kids and my wife out of there as soon as possible.
Yoni, I truly cannot imagine what you are, the fear that you have right now, as you hope that they will be saved.
Free the hostages in Gaza Strip. Free the hostages taken by Palestinians in Gaza Strip. Hamas military. Innocent people and destroy their lives. Bad, bad, bad on you, Hamas. Bad, bad, bad on you, Hamas. Bad, bad, bad on you, Hamas. You should be ashamed of yourself.
They are able to detect where the rockets are flying, then they're fired up, the Iron Dome missiles are fired up and they intercept them in the air. You can just see where the impact bursts were in the sky above us now. Another one being fired up over there, John, if you can see it flying up here. And behind us here above Gaza as well, they're flying up. There's another salvo coming in. I'll get it quiet, we can listen.
Those are not just fireworks, those are missiles.
Israel's Iron Dome defensive system working to protect the people of Israel this evening. Those missiles are coming out of Gaza, perhaps 2.5 miles, well, Gaza is 2.5 miles away, the missiles coming from within Gaza there. For the citizens, the Israeli civilians who live in the towns, Sikkim, Ashkelon, Ashdod, who live along along the coastline here, these Iron Dome rockets are protecting them and their families. And this is very much how the situation is playing out this evening. It is very dynamic. We've heard airstrikes going into Gaza. We've heard helicopter gunships supporting the Israeli Defense Forces on the ground. We saw a tank, an Israeli tank, maneuvering down here just earlier on. And we saw what appeared to be a big column of Israeli Special Forces taking off up the highway here, going someplace we don't know. But it is a very, very active night here right now.
Nick, you know, watching you, I think it just is worth, you're literally watching, you know, what the IDF colonel was just saying. You say that they can't say that they control Israel right now, controls all of its own territory. There is still active fighting. And even now, you talk about 2,200 rockets, you're witnessing more attempts coming in even now.
And that's despite the fact that we know the IDF have been targeting areas within Gaza, Hamas militant areas within Gaza, where they believe rockets are fired, manufactured. They've been targeting those through the day. But it seems very clear, and not surprisingly, that in their planning, Hamas knew there would be response to the Israeli Defense Force when they began with that salvo of 2,200 missiles this morning. They clearly protect some of their missiles. They choose other launch positions for those missiles. They've been doing this for a long time, and they continue to do it. And despite the attacks going into Gaza this evening, stand by, Hamas still able to fire several salvos out. Each time those Iron Dome defense systems kick in, that is in response to another salvo of missiles being fired from Gaza. So I would say in the last 10, 15, 20 minutes perhaps, we've had at least four significant salvos fired out in this area alone, and we were able to see salvos being intercepted further south of us in the direction further down the Gaza Strip, and that in that direction, Aaron.
And Nick, one other
thing. Those are not just fireworks, those are real missiles being fired. Those are not just fireworks in the sky, they're being really fired. Missiles intended to hurt people, destroy property. That's what we're witnessing right now. Israel intercepting rockets near Gaza. Israel intercepting rockets near Gaza. Israel intercepting rockets near Gaza. Intercepting rockets near Gaza. Not just fireworks, but each one of those is a missile being fired, intended to kill and hurt and maim.
Come in to Israeli territory from the sea over there. That was this evening. So it is very active. It is happening in real time. Troops are moving by here. Tanks are moving by here. Iron Dome intercepts are happening literally over our heads. And just on the horizon there, one of those battles for a direct confrontation between the IDF and Hamas militants this evening, where you can see the light on the skyline, Sderot. In that vicinity, we understand there is still active operations ongoing, or have been until very, very recently. It is extremely fluid here right now.
All right, Nick, thank you very much. And we'll continue to go to Nick as he witnesses more of what is a war and what is an operation where Israel is still right now struggling to retain and defend the limits of what is defined as its own territory, 24 hours after all this began. Retired Lieutenant General Mark Hertling is with me. He's the former Army Commanding General Europe and the 7th Army. He was in Israel dozens of times providing air defense support to their army. He's visited their election collection headquarters as well. Robin Wright is with us, fellow at the Woodrow Wilson International Center, and Philip Smith, former SORA fellow at the Washington Institute for Near East Policy. So